Get up! Stop fucking with my weave! Alright, this is the Comic-Con wrap-up. We're doing a Comic-Con wrap-up right now, so... Hershey's going crazy right now, fucking with my weave! I'm gonna fuck my weave up! Fuck, nigga! Stop! No! Come on! Alright, so... We gotta make a discussion right here about Comic-Con. Hershey! Making a discussion about Comic-Con. This is the wrap-up. Just to close out the video. No! And my dog Hershey's tearing it up. Hershey's fucking it up on the ones and twos. Ah! Ah! The hell do you have against my weave, man? Stop playing. Anyway, we had a great time. Tired as hell.
Yeah.
And believe it or not, we didn't pick up any 1/6 scale collectibles. Nothing. No 1/6 scale collectibles were picked up by the Hot Chick. By the Hot Chicks Cool Toy Review crew. So Wendy, what did you think about your first Comic-Con? Popping your cherry at the first Comic-Con. Ow!
It was pretty crazy. I guess since we had been to Frankenstein's, I kind of felt like it was a Frankenstein's experience completely exploded. The main room is basically like a collectible swap meet. Everything you can possibly think of, but then of course all of the TV stuff and the film stuff.
Ah!
all sorts of activities. But we didn't get so involved in those.
We didn't get, yeah.
We kind of decided we wanted to hang out and try and talk to people and take pictures and not wait on any of the crazy, ridiculous lines that people were waiting on for autographs and photos. And
for people we didn't even know who the hell they were.
Well, there were people that we did know who they were. But
people were throwing themselves on the floor like the goddamn Beatles was at Comic-Con or some bitches fainting. It was horrible. Couldn't believe it.
The traffic could get pretty bad at times, but overall, it was an incredible experience. We would definitely want to do it again. Crazy, but...
We met Ansel 2006. Cool cat. We hooked up with Ansel. I hooked up with Lloyd Kaufman from Trauma Films. I did an internship with Trauma Films quite a few years back. I did a couple of DVD covers for them. We bumped into the creator of Fangoria magazine.
If you're into horror, really, you know what we're talking about.
Yeah, really cool cat. We bumped into him. We swapped information with him. We met Bukim Woodbine. Last movie I know him from, Bokeem Woodbine, was from Devil.
He's a security guard.
Somebody asked if that was who?
Dave Chappelle.
Somebody asked if that was Dave Chappelle in the photos.
But it was Bokeem Woodbine.
It was Bokeem Woodbine, yeah, but I know why you could get the brothers mixed up. Somebody else asked us if it was Sticky Fingers from Onyx.
But he has a lazy eye, so that one is kind of bad.
I was like, nah. Anyway, yeah, like I said, we didn't pick up any 1/6 scale collectibles.
But we did pick up some stuff.
Wendy picked up some shoes.
Some.
You know how girls are with their stupid ass shoes?
Yeah, for me, it's like 1/6 scale and shoes, but they were really cool shoes. They had like zombies on them.
I got a bunch of more Star Wars ships for my 3¾-inch collection. I picked up, check this shit out. I picked up the Imperial Shuttle and... Wedge Antilles X-Wing Fighter. And I picked those up for $100 in the box, both of them. Mint pimp boxes. I also picked up a vintage Land Speeder. I picked up an A-Wing Fighter. And I picked up, what else did I pick up? Oh, I picked up one of the large wing TIE Fighters. The one with the, I believe it has the Imperial logos on the wings. It was some exclusive from some crap, but I got all of them for dirt cheap. waited till the last day while everything was wrapping up.
Yeah, that, and just went. That is key, guys. If that's you go it. To Comic-Con and you want stuff, if you snooze, you might lose.
Yep.
But if it's still there on Sunday, people will wheel and deal because they don't want to pack it up.
Everybody turns into crackheads on Sunday. So I was out there like a crackhead spitting on windshields trying to wipe their shit up. You know what I mean? And, yeah, man, we met a lot of cool people. We took a ton of photographs. I got another slideshow I want to put together, which will probably go before this video because this is going to be the wrap up across your ass. And this is Hershy.
Yeah, they came with us and hung out in the hotel.
These are our little Boston Terriers.
Very good.
That's Hershy and Suzy.
Pick Suzy up.
Ugh. That's Suzy.
Suzy, say hi.
These are our little babies. We don't go nowhere without them, obviously. We brought them here. They've been pimping in the hotel for the last week. Hershy took a big ass, beautiful golden dump on the floor the second night we were here.
But that was it.
And man, we had a blast. It was our first Comic-Con. We're definitely coming back next year. Hopefully some of you guys can come out and chill with us next year. And the dopest thing that I got, not Star Wars related, for all of y'all horror fanatics, I picked up from Full Moon. Not only, we got 20 DVDs, including the Subspecies box set, Puppet Master box set,
Blu-ray
Subspecies. We also got a Full Moon Classics DVD box set with like another 5 movies. We got the latest Puppet Master, Axis of Evil.
And then that
freebie DVD,
that new one.
And a freebie DVD, yeah. I forgot, Sid Haig is in it. I don't remember the name of the movie. The Haunted Casino. And I have an actual made by a puppeteer. I have a full scale authentic Blade figure because I'll do a review on it. Mind your business when I'm talking, I'm slap you in your face. Anyway, and also I did pick that up, which I was going out of my mind with that. Obviously, you guys seen the Batmobile. Oh my God, the Hot Toys Batmobile.
Yeah.
When I saw that Batmobile, I had to stop, go to the bathroom, flip my underwears over, come back, and finish watching it.
All right, two things related to that
that
we want to make sure we share.
Yeah.
We asked about pricing.
Yeah.
They said it will not be much more than the original retail price for the tumbler. And
at best, he said $500 at best.
And
this is the coolest.
We did find out because they had seen pictures. They haven't seen it in person
100%
yet,
positive.
But the Michael Keaton is going to be DX. Yes.
Guaranteed, he said 100% positive. Michael Jackson will be DX. You know what I'm saying? I had to put the gun in the mouth on this kid to get that information. But we got that information. Bring it back to y'all, Hot Toys fanatics. And one more thing. I don't know how many of y'all is out there fans like I am, but back from the old school gutter, which we pre-ordered, which is gonna be sick. Can't wait to get it. They made a new Voltron that is, imagine the masterpiece Voltron, 2 feet tall with super highly articulated figures that go
inside
in the lions. Banana clips. The illest Voltron ever. I have the 2 foot tall, I believe it was it made by Toonami? I don't remember. I have the last super, super hot Voltron that came out, which was like the nicest Voltron, but this new one is even better. And basically, you get one every 3 months, one lion with a figure. And this thing is sick. I can't wait to get it. It's an expensive piece, but it's going to be super, super, super hot. And it's easily, I think it clearly is like the coolest transforming robotic toy that I've ever seen. It looks ridiculous. As I get the pieces, you know, I hope the world doesn't end in December, whatever, blah, 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 2012, because I need to finish that fucking Voltron, put that Voltron together, and it's going to take like a year for all the pieces to get here, but I can't wait. I'm gonna definitely put the reviews down on that one when I get that.
And who?
What else?
We still don't know, for sure.
Who what?
The Sideshow guy.
Who's Sideshow? Oh, you know that guy from Sideshow, man.
The one that's in
all the little videos and the preview videos talking about everything with, you know, the guy with the black hair. You'll see him in the photography. Wendy's in a photo with him. But we got to talk to him.
Got to chat with him for a nice while.
We rapped with him for a little while he was trying to, you know what I'm saying. He He was trying to spit game at Wendy, but he didn't know. He didn't know I already had that. You know what I'm saying? But
stop.
He was trying to spit game. Oh yeah, and the ass cheeks you seen on that video.
It's not me.
None of them is Wendy's. There's some girls. I had to take a quick upskirt shot at some girls that I seen.
Upskirt? They weren't wearing skirts.
You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm saying.
It was not difficult at all.
That's what I'm saying. They pulled up their skirts when they saw me with a camera. You know what I mean? So yeah, but that, you know what I'm saying? Those girls that was farting on. And that fart was actually from one of that girl's blowholes. Not that fart. That fart I put on there. But yeah, man, we had a blast. So, and that's about it. And yeah, if there's anything else we forgot, I guess we'll mention it. We got some more reviews coming up.
Come on. I think there's a short line. Come on. Kind of the storyline to the back here.
And here we have my other love. This 3 3/4 inch Star Wars line. Fantastical. We got the vintage 3-packs. Sweet! And these are what are contained in the 3-packs. I believe these are the same figures in the vintage line. Except you don't get all these in the new vintage line. Some of them just aren't available. It's in the way. That Dengar and AT-AT pilot is sick. Check out that vintage land speeder. It's gonna be $17. New Y-Wing coming out. Vintage box, $29.99. It's gonna be sick. Tauntaun, I wonder if that's got a split belly. Yes, that does have an opening belly. And these are some Star Wars Republic Commando packs.
The beauty of this when you couldn't.
Star Wars The Force Unleashed.
That was the beauty of it all. You have to bail away from stuff that never comes
out. Wow, these are all set. Here we have the new B-Wing coming out in the Return of the Jedi box. And that's going to be $35. That looks really cool. Yeah. Kmart only. Fantastic. More of the vintage line stuff. Really cool, Panda Baba.
This is called the vintage collection.
B-Wing pilot. Solo Bespin, Barra Sophie. Rebel Fleet Trooper with the baseball cap, sweet. Stuff. Mandalorian Assault Transport. Republican AV-7 Mobile Cannon. That's pretty sick. This guy's Vulture Droid. Actual battle packs there.
Mini vehicles, speeder bike, Republican Scout speeder, and the Blue Star skiff, attack cycle, speeder bike, Y-Wing clone bomber, scout bomber, large speeder bike, ATRT, pirate speeder bike. Which guy?
Mean guy.
Oh yeah? He just saw you, or you saw him?
We just happened to be standing next to each other, and I was like, oh hey,
and
he's like, hey, what are you doing here?
Like, we live here now.
Yes.
Look at that little bad boy. Those two little tiny ones in the center are gonna be the ones that everybody's gonna try to get when they break those packs apart. Separatist droid gunship, Kip Fisto's Jedi fighter, Obi-Wan's Jedi fighter, Anakin's Jedi fighter, Republic fighter tunnels. That looks really nice back there. It looks like a it looks like an Imperial shuttle almost, yeah. That thing opens up. Attack shuttle. Public attack shuttle. That's really cool. Pretty cool. Piece I want the most. Freaking X-Wing. And Darth Vader's TIE fighter.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
So that means actually you should sit there and then put your foot on.
Yes. I think we should do that.
Okay, camera.
And these are
okay,
new multi packs.
Okay. I want you to see it too.
Oh, it's on the back side. I thought it was something that opened.
It doesn't.
Oh. Oh, these are the these battle packs have been around for a little while. These ain't anything new.
No,
this is all 2011 stuff that's been out.